Slovenian rescuers evacuate five people trapped deep inside a flooded underground cave since Saturday. The head of the rescue mission says they were transported by boat through some sections of the 8.2-kilometer network of underground lakes and walked through others. The five had taken shelter more than 2 kilometers from the entrance to the Krishna Jama cave. Blinken's diplomatic push comes as a suspected Israeli strike killed a senior Hezbollah commander in Lebanon. Wissam al-Tawil was the deputy head of Hezbollah's elite force. He and another fighter were killed some 6 kilometers from the border with Israel. Israel's military did not comment but said it had hit Hezbollah targets in response to cross-border attacks. More than 130 Hezbollah fighters have been killed in the cross-border hostilities since the Israeli-Hamas war broke out. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken back in Israel as part of a diplomatic push to stop the war in Gaza from spreading further. He is set to meet with top Israeli officials to discuss the country's military campaign in Gaza. This is Blinken's fourth trip to the Middle East since October. Prior to visiting Israel, he also went to Jordan and Qatar. Blinken said all the leaders he met are determined to prevent a wider conflict in the region.
The future of the region needs to be one of integration, not division and not conflict. And fourth, for that to happen, we need to see the establishment of an independent Palestinian state. Now, no one I talk to thinks any of this will be easy. All recognize the hurdles, and no one thinks that anything will happen overnight. But we agreed to work together.
Ecuador declares a 60-day state of emergency a day after its most wanted prisoner disappeared from his jail cell. On Sunday, Adolfo Macias, leader of the Los Choneros criminal gang, disappeared from prison where he was serving a 34-year sentence. The state of emergency deploys the military to the streets and prisons. A national nighttime curfew has also been imposed. This is the latest security test for President Daniel Noboa, a young businessman who took office in November. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says Filipinos who are being held hostage by Houthi rebels are being treated well and are in good health. This comes after an official from Yemen met with 17 seafarers aboard the ship last January 2nd, but the agency did not disclose the demands of the Houthi rebels in exchange for their release.
So bottom line is this is actually being closely monitored and that we are actually seeing how we can actually extend whatever assistance that's necessary for the 17 as we continue to work for their early release.
A magnitude 6.7 quake hit waters off Sarangani Island in Davao Occidental early Tuesday. State seismologists downgraded the quake's magnitude from their previous report of 7.1. An intensity 4 tremor was felt in the towns of Malungon, Alabel, Kiamba, and Glan. FIVOX not expecting any damage from the quake. It adds there is no tsunami threat.
Pag intensity 4 po, wala po tayong expected na damage. Nasa dagat na ng Indonesia sa Mindanao Island, 183 kilometers.
The hits just keep on coming for NBA superstar Ja Morant. Fresh from serving a 25-game suspension for his gun-toting antics on social media, the Memphis Grizzlies franchise player is now set to undergo season-ending shoulder surgery. Memphis expects him to be ready for the 2024-2025 season. Morant has just played 9 games this season, marking the first of a 5-year, $197 million contract extension he signed with the Grizzlies. The humble zebra fish is a staple in home aquariums all over the world, but in Stockholm, they've achieved a higher purpose, unlocking the keys to human illnesses. Take a look.
Could these zebra fish be the key to help unlock secrets about human illnesses? Scientists in Stockholm think so. They have bred the blue and silver fish for over 20 years, believing they are key model organisms for medical research.
You can use zebrafish in everything from cancer research. You can transplant cancer cells into the zebrafish and test new cancer drugs. You can study orphan diseases, which are diseases where there is no known cause known yet. You can do toxicology, so screen for substances which are toxic, and much more.
This is the Karolinska Institute's zebrafish core facility. It is home to some 20,000 zebrafish. Lars Brautigam, scientific director of the facility, explains why the fish is a great model organism for medical research.
The genome of the zebrafish has been sequenced many years ago, and people have seen that if you mutate genes in zebrafish, the phenotype, how the zebrafish looks like, resembles very closely to patients that have the same mutations. And then people realized that the genetic environment of the zebrafish and the patients is the same.
Zebrafish have a few advantages that make them favorable in research. They breed quickly and in great numbers. They also develop quickly once hatched and become fully viable and swimming in around 5 days. The fish are also cheaper to breed than mice, which is widely used in scientific research. Zebrafish are clear when they are very young, and the embryos also develop outside their mother, ideal for scientists to study early development.
Well, the short life cycle allows you to run experiments in a very short time because you have a organism that develops very quickly, and that gives you the opportunity to study organ development, to study the brain development or different kind of cancer diseases in a very short time.
Brautigam says his team is testing cancer medications on the fish that will hopefully be useful in helping patients with the disease.
So what we do mostly is we transplant cancer cells into zebrafish embryos, and then we test new medications that will be used hopefully in the future in the clinic. And then we can test in zebrafish embryos if these new medications are better than the existing medications.